The interview given by A. Raja on the campaign trail there to our Chennai reporter Sandhya Ravishankar, and she's on the line with us. We are trying to get the live news feed of that interview, the tape of that interview. I'm sorry, not live. We're trying to get a play out of that from Coimbatore. It may take some time. But once again, before going back to Sandhya, Mohandas Pai, can this just be put aside? Because the Congress Party argument tonight on this breaking story is it doesn't matter, the Congress Party leader says, Abid Rasool Khan, it doesn't matter what Raja is telling Times Now because he's the main accused. We don't believe him.
Well, Arnab, I think Raja has every right to make a statement in his defense. He has been accused, he has been prevented from speaking to the parliamentary, joint parliamentary committee. He should have made his statement as a minister. He should have come out much earlier and given his part of the whole matter so the matter is cleared, because he is facing a criminal charge. He has a right to defend himself. I think he should have spoken out, and if he speaks out now, people should listen. But the people of this country need to know what exactly happened in this entire 3G scam. So I think it's very important for him to speak out, and I think we should listen. Just to dismiss him to say that he's been charged, he's a criminal, I think is unacceptable, because nobody knows the truth as yet. And in his defense, he has not been allowed to speak to the JPC.
No, they are trying to censor him.
JPC, then you can clear the matter.
They are trying to censor him. See, even now, Abid Rasool Khan is interrupting you. Yes, Abid, you can't censor the truth.
Arnab.
Mr. Rasool Khan, you know, it's going to bounce back on you. If you have nothing to hide, don't be so defensive about it.
We are not.
Don't
against,
be so defensive.
Not, I,
don't
I
be
have,
so defensive
Arnab
about
very
it.
Clearly,
Arnab.
I am not against Arnab. Mr. Raja speaking.
Arnab, if I can come in
I am
here,
not against giving him a fair
here,
chance. I am not against giving him a fair trial. But to discuss an unsigned note which he claims to have been given is really not right. The second point
no,
is...
No, so you're saying he's lying.
Should have come much
you're
earlier.
Saying he's lying.
He should have come out with
Arnab.
The facts.
You're saying
earlier.
He's lying, right?
Arnab,
what is your
report.
Point? You're saying the
let
minister...
Report,
the, you're saying Raja is lying. Even without
Arnab.
Hearing the interview, you're saying Raja is lying. So you have taken a position on it. What's
Arnab.
There to debate? Yes, Devang Nanavati?
Arnab, you know, the very fact that when you have one accused who is caught for a crime, why do you ask for his interrogation? So that you get the name of other accomplice and other co-accused and you unravel the mystery and the crime. So now that is what is happening with Mr. Raja. So why is it that
first
we should not listen to what he is saying?
We know all that. First of all, you unravel the crimes of Gujarat where you are not able to even get one person to
Arre,
jail.
Mr. Rasool, get out of 2002. You have lost three
here.
Elections. You are about
what
to
are
lose the Lok Sabha election
what
before
are you
2002.
All
so now why are you now getting into this
has been
ridiculous
by the
circumstances?
Court.
Don't reduce the debate to a political shouting match. Don't reduce the debate to a political shouting match.
You
represent a party.
First, enter your house.
Oh, yeah. You don't teach me the right, Mr. Rasool.
House,
you represent a party who brought in emergency when one bench of the High Court set aside the election of your Prime Minister. And you want to
sir,
teach us the morals of democracy.
I'm telling you,
so
I really
please be quiet, you have no moral authority.
You
represent
have,
a party.
You
represent a party who brought in emergency. Where is the question of that?
Yeah,
that's precisely what I'm saying. Look back at 1975.
You are going on a totally different route.
These are not technical grounds.
You have loyalty.
Yeah, no different route. These are the routes.
No, no. What Raja is saying. What Raja is saying, Mohandas Pai. No, Rashid Kidwai, what Raja is saying. And you know, Rashid Kidwai, your argument does not hold here, really. You know, you also taking the Congress Party line, saying that, you know, this is all an accused person saying these things, you can't listen to him, therefore. What is Raja saying, Rashid Kidwai? Raja is saying that I was not allowed to speak before the JPC. Had it been defended properly before Parliament and before the JPC, the case would not have turned out to be this way. Now, if he had gone before the JPC, 1 minute, don't get impatient. Raja was begging, and he was begging. He begged four times. He wrote to the Speaker, let me appear before the JPC, let me appear before the JPC, right? You don't let him speak before the JPC. In any case, the JPC, the UPA was in a, you know, I don't know whether it was in a majority, in the JPC. I suspect that it was. So you don't let him go before the JPC. Now he's saying that the Prime Minister forwarded an unsigned note. And that unsigned note, I told the Prime Minister, went against the recommendations of the NTP 1999. It's a serious point. So even if he's an accused, I'm not taking his point at face value. But can you just throw it aside? One of the biggest scams in the country, Rashid Kidwai, the man doesn't deserve to be heard. I'm not saying, I completely believe that Raja was a kingpin. But if the kingpin is revealing the bigger story, Should he be censored if there is a bigger story?
No, not at all. In fact, Mr. Raja has done a good thing by coming out and saying, speaking to your channel and revealing spilling beans. Only thing is that because I was just pointing at that atmosphere that we are in the midst of election and this kind of revelation can have a kind of political connotation. Second point is that Mr. Raja is saying in his, whatever I have heard, he is saying that the Prime Minister also was in agreement with him. Then who was that political master who was running a kind of cartel or was patronizing it? Mr. Raja should speak correct. Up and should speak truth. The good part about truth is that you don't have to remember anything. He must come out openly and say what
the Congress party wants him censored. Abid Rasool Khan wants him to be censored. He's afraid today.
I am saying that as a citizen of this country.
I am not afraid.
Let Mr. Raja say that who prevailed upon Prime Minister if Prime Minister was not in agreement.
Note by an accused as an afterthought is not right.
I have Sankarshan also on the phone line. We have two journalists from the Telegraph today. One second, Rashid Kidwai. Your colleague Sankarshan is with us on the phone line. Sankarshan, quick comment. A. Raja has given his first ever interview to a TV channel. He's given it to Times Now, where he says that an unsigned note given to the Prime Minister by telecom companies regarding spectrum auction and how subscriber criteria can be devised. This was sent to Raja before taking any decision that I may be apprised. I replied to the Prime Minister saying the suggestions are against the telecom policy. So he has basically said that there was a note prepared by these corporates which was forwarded to me, an unsigned note, forwarded to me from the Prime Minister's office. Sankarshan, what do you think? Now, there is one view the Congress party says this is all rubbish. He's an accused. We can't listen to him. What do you think?
No, you, Arnab, I think just because he is an accused, we will not listen to him is no argument.
There you are. There you are, Mr. Rasool.
He is a key player in that whole scam or scandal.
I said unsigned note.
He has said...
What unsigned? Don't laugh it off, Mr. Rasool.
No. What Mr. Raja says now, and now he is a candidate from the Nilgiris in Tamil Nadu. Mr. Raja is an important politician, say what you will. He has been a key minister in government in the center, at the center of a huge controversy in UPA too. So what he says cannot be brushed aside. Having said that, I will say that there is more than meets the eye in how this decision was taken. There are revelations to be made. There are, in my perception, things that have been hidden, brushed under the carpet. There is a lot of rhetoric between the Congress party and the DMK on this issue, and many fewer facts. So if Mr. Raja is saying something new, I think he needs to be listened to seriously, and I think there is a responsibility on the UPA government, which is still in battle, to furnish answers to what Mr. Raja is saying.
Okay.
I think that this should come out in the public deserves to know.
Well, Mr. Raja has made the point. Sankarshan, thanks. Devang Nanavati, Abid Rasool Khan, Mohandas Pai, Rashid Kidwai, T.S. Krishnamurti, that interview, thank you very much for joining us. That interview with Mr. A. Raja, the news feed is coming in from Coimbatore and should be with us in about 15 minutes. So stay with us on Times Now. That story is going to be big. Thanks very much, gentlemen, for joining me on that.